Hi everyone, welcome to Reverie Hill. My name is Hillary. I'm so excited you're watching this video today because I'm here with a very special guest and her name is Lynn. So everyone, meet Lynn.
Hi.
So for those of you that you haven't met Lynn before, I kind of want to let you know a little bit of something that I've noticed about Lynn and her character. So Lynn just has a heart for others in every context that I've ever known her, she just has a heart for others. She's serving others. She's looking out for other people's needs. She just has a heart for others. And Lynn, I really do think you have like eyes to see the struggles in the world around you. And you have a heart to jump in and really just try and take care of things for people. So that being said, a while ago, you had come to me with an idea for a collaboration that we could work on together. And so, for everyone watching, if you could just kind of explain what that collaboration would be, who we would be working with, and what that would sort of look like, and maybe the heart behind it.
Okay. On a previous trip I had taken to Cambodia, I met a group of men and women who are greatly struggling financially to feed their families. In such case, it is often easy to fall prey to human trafficking traps to make money. This was the case for some of these people. So my heart is so hurt, pain, and I'm crying thinking about it. They are starving, trying to make ends meet, and crying to God every day. With this struggle, they have been taking advantage of it off in the past. And they have been emotionally abused. They work hard and long for job that both treat them well and can feed their families. I then saw what Hillary was doing, supporting Fair Label manufacturing of her clothing. I knew I want to talk to her about working with these men and women. And I know Hillary see how such a beautiful heart, love and care. And I know if this she say yes, but first I kind like very scared because like it's so far, it's overseas. And I think if you know something that work, it life change and they can have like, you know, like valuable, so they can work like human right. Yeah.
So for myself, knowing Lynn and knowing her heart, I just, anything that she comes to me with that's on her heart, I'll do anything to back anything I can. And so for myself, when she came to me with this collaboration, I just really felt like, yes, let's make this happen. Let's do this. And so we began talking logistics and kind of trying to figure out how we would do this and when. And so I'm very pleased to report that we are going to be going over there in January to kind of build the foundation for a collaboration that we hope goes on for a long time and provides fair labor living wages and we can treat them the way they deserve.
to be treated kindly.
So Lynn, you know the area that we're going to be traveling to when we go to Cambodia because you grew up in Cambodia.
Yeah.
As such, growing up in Cambodia, you also sit here as a survivor of the Khmer Rouge takeover. For those of you watching, she's going to get into it a little bit more about what the Khmer Rouge was. But just to kind of set it up, it took place during the 1970s. And even though it took place back in the 70s, it's still very fresh in the minds of the people who live in Cambodia, as it affected the whole country, as well as the family members of those we're gonna work with when we're in Cambodia, whose parents might have also gone through the Khmer Rouge as Lynn did. So yeah, she's just gonna share a little bit about her story to help us kind of understand the history of Cambodia. And yeah, I thank you so much for sharing your story on this. And I'll pass it on to you.
Okay. I grew up in the capital city of Cambodia called Phnom Penh and survived the Khmer Rouge, which truly is a genocide. It was a genocide.
Yeah.
The people from the countryside province of Cambodia wanted to overthrow the government and the capital city of Phnom Penh to create a communist society in which no one owned anything.
Yeah.
They hacked everyone from city who was educated, and they would kill anyone that could read and write. So I would pretend that I couldn't read or write. I was almost 18 years when that Khmer Rouge come take over. During Cambodian New Year, I at a friend's house to celebrate. And at that time, it caused me to be separate from my family from the very beginning of the Khmer Rouge takeover. The Khmer Rouge soldier just told us to get out from the city, to get out from home, and then because they're gonna clear the bomb, it's very dangerous, and we can return in 3 days. But it lied. I saw them steal stuff when we left the house. And the soldier, the Khmer Rouge soldier, they wave gun or point at us and yelling, tell us to go where they want us to go. Yeah. We all live as migrants, slaves to the Khmer Rouge regime. We work hard, starving, that no medicine, only one kind of the medicine, anything that you said. And we do like grow or produce something, they wouldn't let us to eat, they not allow us to eat that around us, and then we want to take it and eat. They will say that we are stealing, they don't like it, and they kill. So it, they would kill, I see like a lot of people, they kill in front of me. So when I work, like we work one place, like grow a lot or something, and then they send us, they said they need us to go another place, just go. We hide, we walk, starving, a lot of people dead, yeah. So I like wish, you know, like wish that we dead, because like it easy to lose hope. It's very hard. The Khmer Rouge genocide is a big part of Cambodian history.
Thank you for sharing that. I mean, when I hear all, I mean, I've heard your story in its entirety, and just in hearing the things that you've been through, I feel like the things that we might complain about on a regular basis, they just seem so trivial, you know, when put in perspective of experiences such as yours. I mean, your story is so powerful because, I mean, as you said, it would be very easy to lose hope. And yeah. I think you sit here today because you didn't lose hope. And obviously there's more to Lynn's story that we wouldn't be able to do justice of telling in its entirety in this interview alone. So we are currently working on getting her book in its full entirety down in book form. So we will keep you updated on that as well as our trip to Cambodia.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for being here and telling your story. And thank you guys for watching this.